right, thanks to Secular Advocacy TV for giving me this golden platform to, you know, air my position, take my stance on the issue of Nigerian cleric Jeremiah, who is facing criticism for advertising a product unregistered that also ignited the administrative reaction, an administrative decision from NAFDAC. Actually, some persons have, you know, supported the action of these clerics, while some have, you know, criticized him for playing on the intelligence of Nigerians. And kudos to Very Dark Man. Now, my stand as one of those that support true secularism in Africa, my stand is that the action of NAFDAC is okay. In fact, it's long overdue, because the provisions of Section 1 of Food, Drugs and Other Related Product Registration Act is against sales, advertisement and manufacture of unregistered products, and which is an offense. And my problem is, he did stated that this product was registered by, or these products per se were registered by NAFDAC. In a video, you can watch the video.
This so NAFDAC approved NAFDAC number. Is this so? I am not from
a... Whereas it was not registered. He did not only breach the provisions of Food, Drugs and Other Related Product Registration Act. He breached the provisions of NAFDAC, because under Section 5 sub F of NAFDAC, NAFDAC is empowered with the responsibilities of registering products. He did not just breach the NAFDAC Act, he also breached that said provision that requires registration of food and other products before you can advertise, sell or even manufacture it. That is it for that. And you may be wondering why I keep mentioning food. Under Section 20 of Food and Drugs Act, water is regarded as food. So if you are selling a product, whether faith, I don't even know the this obsession about faith-based. Anything that you are doing as a church or any religious organization that pertains to business, you have to register it under NAFDAC so that you can pay the necessary taxation. You know, this issue of the cleric Jeremiah goes to the integrity of most religious organizations. It opens the floodgate of the need for us to begin to criticize these set of persons, people respect as clerics, because they tend to enjoy certain immunity in Nigeria. And the last time I checked, the only constitutional bodies that have immunity in Nigeria is the president and his vice, the governor and his deputy. And there is also diplomatic immunity pursuant to Section 308 of the 1999 Constitution and the provisions of Diplomatic Immunities and Privileges Act. That is the only persons, if you read these two provisions, where you can see some those that have immunity. In the Constitution, I did not see any place that states that religious bodies has immunity. It's only state that people have right to freedom of thought, conscience and religion. And that right to freedom of religion is not absolute. So in order to preserve public safety, morality and even public health, you can, you know, derogate upon, you can restrict this religious right. If you go to Section 45 of the 1999 Constitution, the same constitution that gave you guys this right that you are parading and wants to begin to enjoy some immunity. I heard his lawyers saying that that faith-based product, or implying that faith-based product is not subject to regulation. I wonder what he meant by faith-based product. Does faith-based product supersede public health? I want his lawyer to answer this question. Does the fact that it is a faith-based product supersede public health? If the answer is no, then he should be regulated by NAFDAC to ensure that it is fit for consumption. It is fit for purpose. Exactly. NAFDAC is the major agency that preserves consumer protection. Consumer protection rests on NAFDAC. That is why every other agencies, for instance, Federal Competition and Consumer Protection Commission, works, collaborates with NAFDAC to ensure that consumers are well protected. So let us stop manipulating the unsuspecting masses in the name of religious organization. So anyone that sees Very Dark Man Again, or if he's listening to Secular Advocacy TV, he should know that I Obasike Chukwu, appreciate him specially for speaking up. Because some of the gullible Nigerians may not be able to speak up the way he is doing. So I support him. He did not just breach the extant consumer protection laws. He also deceived the people. He said that the product was NAFDAC registered, whereas NAFDAC has come to debunk it. In law of thought, if you make any representation of fact, that people will rely on and incur damages, and those statements are in fact not true. It amounts to deceit. So I think the religious leaders should actually understand that the social media is beginning to make the youths wise. The youths are now wise. It is not the era where our fathers that don't have access to internet can be deceived. Now we are the enlightened youths. So I thank Very Dark Man, and I also advise the Nigerian clerics and other people to take precautions, to be law abiding. Don't use the respect, the unmerited respect you get from the people. Don't use it against them. Don't do something that will affect the people. You have to encourage good values. You have to encourage lawfulness, obedience to the law, to the rule of law. You have not. I mean, this cleric has not. Stating that the product was registered whereas it was not is wrong. Then breaching the provisions of the Food, Drugs and Other Related Product Registration Act, and also the NAFDAC Act, it is to right the wrong. Thank you.